This is a presentation from the research team that organized these symposiums. We are working since late 90s. Since 2011 began those symposiums. And something we are trying to do is to produce software with commercial quality to the architects in some areas, some fields that those tools are lacking because they are are developed in the research they are in a level in the development level that are not akin to be presented to a large public of architects. That is our intention. Well, we produce some pieces of software, and the last one is this one is AppSpace 3D. Is something that there will be some discussion in this symposium about this software. I'm not developing this team. What I am trying to do is to present a new research field we are trying to develop in our research team. It is something that we call ontology-based design, design automation, to fulfill the tasks of main task, creative task, and not those that are present in our current software aids to architects. The main problems we can encounter in you can see in actual computer-aided design software, COT software, commercial off-the-shelf. I say the current types, the current tools in computer-aided design is that they are not directed to the creative part of architecture. The first, I would say there are two generations of computer-aided design tools. The first one is something like this. And this type of CAD were directed to help drawing. The second generation is, you can see there an example of those type of CAD. The second generation is directed under their evolutions. For example, BIM, they are directed not to the creative part of architecture, but to the construction tier of the of all the work involved in the construction industry. So, architects have a few instruments to develop with formal instruments and digital tools to develop the what is in fact the profession of the architect, and it's not a drawing and it is not construction, but is the fulfillment of human and social needs in the construction and the built environment. The architect is the the guarantee of those the guarantee of those uses of the construction that fulfill the needs of the people and societies. One of the greatest of those problems is the organization of the human activities. Well, none of those problems is addressed by those two generations of CAD tools. Well, those are examples of developments of CAD tools for BIM. BIM and the second generation CAD are indeed very helpful instruments, but not to the creative part of architecture. So there are very many narrowness to solve. Some of them are expressed there. There is no knowledge involved of a relation between social and human function of the spaces and the definition of those spaces. Those relationships, what I could say architectural theory, are not expressed in those computer aided design tools. I'm not going to develop those topics I have there. Well, now I must arrive to what are our solutions. Well, what we think will be a solution is what we can import from artificial intelligence. This is a very confusing model of what is an agent for artificial intelligence. I have here a much compact scheme. Well, an agent for artificial intelligence must have a process of knowledge that is obtained either from the world, from the knowledge of the world, either from introduction of something that is already known and people can bring to the experts, can bring to the artificial intelligence. Then we have values. This is very important because there is no way to base decision only on knowledge. We have to introduce the values, human and social values, that determine what is the direction of the action. We have to introduce knowledge and values to take decision process, and that is it's in the center of that scheme there. And then we must take actions. For the architect, the action is in the form of projects in the process of design. Well, I'm passing there. We will have time to discuss more in a few moments. What are our guess that will be the development of, well, I would say a third generation computer-aided design tool? Our guess is not very far from the development of Dreamweaver from Autodesk, but there are a few differences. Well, the first is the definition of knowledge in an ontological form. Well, ontologies are descriptive language. Well, they don't act, but they can increase knowledge capacity in a descriptive form. We can describe our knowledge on architecture in the form of ontologies. Ontologies are very formal language, based most of them in near first logical, first order logics. They have some advantage over other types of logics because they can accommodate well, contradictions. Although, well, the most known logic don't accommodate for contradictions, and the development of ontologies, they can accommodate. And that is very important because ontologies are a process of many actors interact in the development of knowledge. You can say that in what we're trying to do, there are many intervenients with very different goals, and they have to collaborate. But their collaboration does not need to be completely perfect. There can be some disturbance in that collaboration. Ontologies are very akin to that kind of development. So it is our guess that this is the way that we can develop. We can develop well, the depository of architectural theoretical knowledge. Well, there are tools that are well current in ontology domain, and we decided to go for them. It's the language is Web Ontology language, known as O. There is a development environment from University of Stanford, his protege, and there are many other tools that you can, well, they are current in, well, the community that deals with ontologies that can provide a certain degree of, well, they are already known by many people. There is a critical mass that can develop in this with this technique. Well, second is it's not enough to have a descriptive language. We must act with that language. And well, the second tier of our research is develop not only a language, but reasoning or reasoning tools that can create, departing from that knowledge, that can create well, what we want, that is the project of the architect. Not in its final form, of course, but helping the work of the architect. Those reasoning tools are also very formalized in ontologies, so we can develop those reasoning tools with some soundness, because it is formalized, and a great openness, because they are very poor, very powerful. So it will be it's the other aspect we are trying to develop. There are some kind of potentialities that we could see in the use of ontologies, and there are some other fields that can be developed, not only in the project or design process, but in all those aspects that you can see there in the slide. Our goals in this project is, as you can see there, a set of products: foundations, ontologies for architecture and urbanism, some subdomains, design automation, integration with well-known tools, BIM and ISCs, interfaces with well-developed tools for engineering, environmental, structural, and so on, interfaces with well-developed scientific field in architecture, space syntax, and many others products. You can see there that the goal is not only the automation tools for architectural design, although that is the main goal of the project, and but also there are other fields where ontologies and reasoning tools over those ontologies can be developed also. An institutional platform. And this is why we are presenting here this project, because we need partners. This is a gigantic task, as you can see, and only with collaboration between many research teams that can be taken to a good end. Of course, this is not the first time the problem is addressed. We are not inventing these methodologies, but we intend to collaborate with many other teams in this objective. This is a design of ontology. We developed already an ontology for architecture. This is maybe very confusing, because there are hundreds of abstract concepts that are correlated in the ontology. I have here the main concepts that we are trying to deal with, and those are, I'm sorry. Well, this is in Portuguese. I must translate to English, because I think this is important. In the first place is the type of persons, of people. They have activities that have processes that are sets of movements. They practice some schedule. They have some environment features and necessities, and they need equipment. All these have some requirements, environment requirements. Well, I would say the most important in our analysis is space, but there are many others like accessibility, visibility, noise, lighting, security, some characterization of the of air, quality of air. Well, there are people that live in an environment. That environment also has some spatial characteristics and some environmental characteristics. Constructive elements have also some environment characteristics. Well, those are the main concepts that we develop for the ontology of architecture. But as you can guess, there are already developed hundreds of other concepts that are related with this. What these try to say is, global scheme is that people act in an environment, they need space, they make movements, and they need some environment conditions, and space and elements of and constructive elements can provide that space, that environmental conditions. Well, when we say that we need something for people to live, we can obtain, if we have that knowledge in an ontology, we can query the ontology and obtain the desired space and the environmental characteristics or features that must fulfill the desires of the work of people living in that environment. Well, I'm going to show a small example. We are still in our very beginning. It is a kindergarten. Well, I must say that this project is not at the very beginning. We are working already with some other schools. We indeed tried to get some funding from Horizon 2020. We made a project, and there were some different approaches to the creation of ontologies. Our own solution is what we say, what we call a heuristic solution. We go to the already known theoretic architecture, and here we are only dealing with the space needs, and there are thousands of books and papers on this issue. So there is a not yet formalized, but there is a very big research on this team. Well, I think everybody knows Neufert. You go to Neufert to know the dimension of some of a kitchen or something like that. Well, there are the research is centennial, and there is a very big effort in this in this kind of problems. There are other approaches for ontologies. As you can see, our approach, we are dealing with this this kind of approach because there are others. This kind of approach is heuristic, but there is another kind of approach, heuristics, that they are associated with the name of shape grammars. In the case of shape grammars, it's a little different from this, because in the definition of the ontologies, they have already actions to create design. Our approach is there is no action, is only declarative what we put in the ontology. And the reasoning tool, yes, in the reasoning tool there is actions to produce the design. But space grammars already introduce in the ontology through the form of rules of production of the grammar of shapes, and it's a little different. Well, for example, University of London is working of Lisbon, sorry, is working on that that solution. But there are other solutions that are non-heuristic. In those solutions, we don't go to see what already is known in architectural literature, but we go to examples in architecture and we try to understand. Well, understand is underscores because well, there are processes in ontologies that we retire rules without perfectly understanding what is under those this knowledge. In non-heuristic, they are very most used in everything. Neural networks and percepticons and diffuse logics and so on are non-heuristic trends to arrive to ontologies or to knowledge without knowing very well what understanding. The knowledge is not based on understanding, but in other correlation of variables. Well, our solution is we go to the bibliography, to the literature of architecture, we retire what is known. For example, it is for the kindergarten, what is needed in a kindergarten, the spaces that you need, the dimensions that you need, and then you put that on the ontology, and then with reasoning tools, very, very abstract and general reasoning tools, we can make a distribution of spaces and the interface between those spaces. Well, that's one of the levels of the design of the kindergarten, is the whole location with interior and exterior places, and the relations between those spaces. This is the interior of the kindergarten. The spaces with, well, shapes are not yet developed in our model, only volumes and you can see in the scheme, and the relations between volumes. Well, the main variable to optimize that we are dealing with is accessibility, but many others will be introduced to define the reasons why use some shape, why this room must be near that room, why there is an interface between two rooms. it is a wall or something else, or is a door or window, or what characteristics of the constructive element must be produced to fulfill the environment problem that we are dealing. Well, of course, we are dealing with real examples, and what you are trying is to create a reasoning tool that is can be generalized to create any kindergarten. We would say we need a kindergarten for 15 or 100 children. How would it be like? It's not very different what you see here from what you see here. This is a scheme that represents more or less what is a real kindergarten. It's not by chance, because we introduce the data that create that project in particular. Not that project, but many projects. So when you can, well, it's not surprising that we obtain the results that are the common practice of architects. What we are trying to do is not another, a better architect, but is formalizing what good architect does, not nothing more than that. Well, this is the third level. Is the interior of the rooms, the distribution here, it is much more particular. We must make the distribution of, well, concrete pieces of equipment needed. Well, here it's a very much difficult, much more difficult way to arrive to a good solution. Well, I'm ending here, only to say that what we are trying to, we are not trying to end in the scheme, but to transform then the scheme to real project. And there are already tools. This is another part of the global set of works that we must do. Well, several works. One of them is surprisingly from the 60s, from a well-known architect in Portugal when he was very young, in the 60s of last century, is Nuno Portas, with they were the fathers of artificial intelligence in Portugal. They worked all in National Laboratory of Civil Engineering in the time, and they produced from schemes to real design of the project, of architectural project. This is not from them, but is from the third symposium we had 2 years ago. Presented by those were the subscribers of the paper, Krishnender, something that I can't spell, and José Eduardo. There is also optimizing distribution of spaces to create the optimized. Beginning in the sketch and trying to create a real project, architectural project. This is not the this kind of work is already developed. What is not very well developed is the knowledge to create the scheme, and that is what you are trying to develop. Of course, the final goal is to arrive to the capacity of exporting all these to complete projects, of course, always with the intervention, work of the real architect, because it's impossible to create projects without by pure automation, without the intervention of the real architect. And but the final result of IOGO is the creation of BIM, BIM projects with the help of what we are trying to do. Well, I'm sorry. I'm open to your questions. And more than that, I'm hoping that some of you would be interested in participate in this effort and go to a further collaboration.
Thank you. we need to introduce Professor Pankwis, one of the researchers for our research center in ESA, the Laboratory for Research in Architecture, is dealing with computation and is the form of engineering, also in scripting, and is also connected to another project that is being developed that you will hear about it tomorrow with the presentation from Katarina. Now I will open a period of discussion before coffee break, and I hope you have some questions for us.
Well, no question. I would say that there will be a question because this is so controversial problem.
Yes.
The automation of the architectural design, that there must be a question there.
What do you expect will be the reaction of architects to these two? I understand that this could be very useful, mainly in large projects and complex projects, for instance, an hospital, which is so complex that this could really help. But what do you think is the reaction from architects, which are beings that know everything, and what do you think they will react to this? The interaction between this software, this ontology, and the creative work of architects, what will be the reaction of them?
Want to respond now or any other question? Yes.
Victor, I can see that on your diagrams, especially with the circles and the rectangles, it's very clear that programmatically it's completely solved. I would like to understand if there is some way to analyze the spatial qualities of this kind of organization.
Well, I think that a full automation of project is beyond our imagination. We cannot think of that. But well, I would follow the engineering process. Well, I am engineer, must say. I have a very known engineering in Porto already. That is old engineering that made some of the good examples of engineering in Porto. When I work with him and I try to implement computational studies of his work. One of the greatest buildings here in Porto, it's the tallest building when he constructed or he projected that building. Well, he said, I spent 6 months calculating this building. And now I was on the computer, you make the same things in 6 minutes. When I finish the project, I say, what an engineer I am. And now in 6 minutes, the machine makes the same thing. Well, of course, the engineer is needed. It's not dispensable by the machine. What he makes is another thing, not sums and multiplications, but the creative part of engineering. He does not have to make the calculations because the machine is much better than a person to make that. And what he makes is global design of the structure. And he thinks on what is really creative. What I would say in architecture is, well, I suspect it will be the same thing. The architect does not need to be aware of everything in architecture because there are many things that can be made without the intervention, because it's something that is well known. The process of creating that design is already known. There is nothing new. but there are many things that are new, and that is what the architect may produce. It's exactly the creative part. What is not creative, the machine can do. Well, I think this is the normal path of everything. When now an automobile has many digital aided, the driver is aided by many digital tools in the car. Well, if you want to be creative, it can be, but well, those tools are very, very important, and I think in everything, this is the path we are making in every field of our activity. It's what I think. Of course, in our solution, there will be many things, and there are parameters that in every stage of our process, what you're trying to do, where the architect will introduce what he feels, what is the feeling, because there are many variables that he can control in many ways. And there are things that there will be never a solution, a formalized solution. It's what I think. Relative to your questions, well, we are trying to, for the moment, we are dealing with volumes, quantity of space, but not with shapes for the moment. We are not dealing with shapes, but although shapes and the variable that we are dealing is accessibility, but there will be many others in the beginning because, well, I would say, and I defend this, the main problem in architecture is what the architect makes is conforming the human life in space. It creates spaces for people to live. And what the architect do is molding space. you understand me. Architect molds space. And the space is molding life of people. Of course, the inverse may be more true. Through even life of people, mode space. It's a correlation between the both. Well, we are trying to deal with human activities that are well established, and you can read in many, many books. There is no controversial issues in those things. And it's what we are trying to do now. But shapes, yes, they will be another issue that we'll deal with later. Well, for example, space syntax can deal with some characteristics of quality of space. And we are trying to implement some link from space syntax with this model. So, quality of space will be an issue that we are trying to deal, but not for this moment.
I would like to highlight this relation between these two questions that I think they are really important for the rest of the symposium. It's how to establish the relation between creativity, quality of space, and what we think about quality of space. What is quality of space? This is not a linear discussion. This is not something that we can establish in a very clear equation, a mathematical equation, because quality of space has a lot of inputs that are not clear to or not the same to all of us. So this is one of the main goals of the symposium, as you will see during the days, and that's why the symposium is not about a specific approach, a specific methodology, a specific method, but trying to understand how we can correlate all of them to achieve this, to achieve creativity, design, to achieve quality of space, and to get the best of each methodology, despite of the limitation that all of them has. So, before we go to the coffee break, that is already set, if no one has another question, I would like to stress this triangulation, this correlation between these three main issues that will be all together during these 2-3 days that we be together here. It's creativity, quality of space, and formalization. How do we formalize this? How do we formalize quality of space, and how do we need to formalize creativity? So this is one of the things that I think it will be as a common ground for our future discussions, and I hope you